Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it. I have no power of my own. Holy Spirit, I look unto you. Help me, I have no power of my own. I have no power of my own. I have no power of my own. Holy Spirit, I look unto you. Help me, I have no power of my own. You need his help. I do need his help. I know without him, I can do but nothing. If truly you need his help, you want him to send help to you today through his word, then bow down your head as we pray. Our Lord and our God, we want to appreciate you for another beautiful opportunity you have given to us to fellowship together with you. We are grateful, we are grateful, we are grateful. We are grateful for giving us life. We are grateful for the salvation of our souls. We are grateful for keeping us in your love. We are grateful that you still answer prayers. We are grateful that you have exchanged all our weaknesses with your strength. Lord, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Father Divine, all that you can do in the life of those who love you, Father, please do in our lives today in Jesus' name. We want to register it again and again that we love you, Father. We love you, our Lord, because you are the first to love us. Therefore, Lord, because we love you, all the blessings that you release over those who love you, because your word said, I love those who love me. King of glory, because we love you, we pray you will love us in return and make our lives to be a living testimony, a living proof of your power, of your favor, of your mercy in the name of Jesus. We are gathered here again, O God, to hear your voice. Speak to us, Lord, in the languages we understand, that each one of us that is viewing this program will be blessed through the word in Jesus' name. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today is Saturday, 22nd of July. To God be the glory. The topic says misdirected request. Misdirected request. We all know that God wants us to make requests. But when we make this request, where do we channel them through? Do we send the request to the direct place or we misdirect it? By the time we are concluding this word of today, we'll be able to know. Maybe you too, you have been misdirecting your request, or you have been directing it to the right channel. And if you have been misdirecting it before, I pray that the Holy Spirit will help you to begin to channel it through the Lord Jesus Christ henceforth in Jesus' name. Misdirected request. Our memory verse is taken from James chapter 4 and verse 3. James chapter 4 and verse 3. Ye ask and receive not, because ye ask amiss, that ye may consume it upon your lust. Quickly, may I say one or two things here. God looked into your heart. God looked into my heart to see the reason why we are making that request. Human being, we only listen to the word of your mouth and say, hey, this is what he said he need. They don't know why you need it. Maybe you are saying, God, bless me. Give me money. Give me money. Give me wealth. Lord, give me wealth. Others who know your condition will be saying, amen. Amen. Ah, he needs wealth. Ah, God needs to change his story. The question is, why do you need the wealth? Maybe because you too, you want to feel belong. You want to be among the class of the rich, so to say. So it's because of class, because of status. That's why you want wealth. Or maybe because you want to build houses all over the world. You want to travel all over the world. Just enjoy. That's why you want the wealth. Or maybe you are saying, Lord, try me with your wealth. I will prove to you you have a son. I will prove to you you have a daughter. I will use the money to buy vehicles for evangelical departments to go about preaching your word. I will use the money to pay house rent for churches that I need fix. I will use the money to build churches for you all over the world. I will use the money to propagate the gospel through media. Why do you make that request? James 4:3 says, ye ask and receive not. Why? Because ye ask amiss, that ye may consume it upon your lust. If the reason why you are asking for that blessing has nothing to do with God, you are not likely to receive it. If you are asking for wealth, like I've said, because of class, God will not give you that money. But if you want to use the money to expand his kingdom, you have read in Zechariah 1:17, you know that, you need to publish this kingdom work. That's why you want wealth. He will give it to you. Why do you make requests? Because if we can look into our hearts, if we change our motive, then we begin to receive answers to our prayers. That thing you are asking for, what is the motive behind it? Why do you want it? If it is to be consumed for your lust, answer might not come. Our text is taken from Genesis 30, verse 1 and 2. Genesis chapter 30, verse 1 and 2. And when Rachel saw that she bare Jacob no children, Rachel envied her sister and said unto Jacob, give me children, or else I die. And Jacob's anger was kindled against Rachel, and he said, am I in God's stead? Who has withheld from thee the fruit of the womb? You see, misdirected requests. God is the giver of children. From the answer of Jacob here, we can see God is the giver of children. Genesis 30, verse 22. And God remembered Rachel, and God hearkened to her and opened her womb. 23 says, and she conceived and bare a son and said, God has taken away my reproach. So God is the giver of children. Brethren, those of us that are waiting on God for the fruit of the womb, don't let's remove our focus from him. You want children, he is the giver. Children can only come from him. Genesis 25, verse 21. Genesis 25, 21. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah, his wife, conceived. So, you want children? Cry to God. Hold on to him. Psalm 127, verse 3. Psalm 127. We look at verse 3. It says, "Lo, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward." They are God's heritage. He owns them, and he gives them to whoever he pleases. And one thing I know, for you, my viewer, that is trusting God for the fruit of the womb, he will give you children, twins, triplets, as your heart desires, he will give it to you. How do I know? Because you are his child, his word says, none shall be barren in the land. Because you are his child, you have made up your mind to obey him, to follow him all the days of your life. His word can never be fulfilled over your life. The word has gone forth. It will not return to you void without accomplishing the purpose for which it is being sent. You will be fruitful in the name of Jesus. So, God is the giver of children. In Matthew 6, 9 to 13, let's see what is it that is written there. Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 to 13. After this manner, therefore, pray ye. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is thy kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The Lord taught his disciples the right way to pray. We are afraid. Prayer is an outcry for assistance. What is prayer? You are saying, this thing is beyond me. I need help. It summons your ally to join forces with you in your fight against your foes in order to be victorious. Usually, when an individual encounters a problem too big to handle, he will call for the help of others. I say, this load is beyond me. I need help. Please, come to my aid. In the midst of famine, when Elijah went to ask for water and food from the widow of Zarephath, he was simply praying. 1 Kings 17, 8 to 16. 1 Kings 17, 8 to 16. He was simply praying. He was asking for help. Also, when this widow's son died and she cried to the man of God to restore him back to life, that was a prayer. Let's turn our Bibles to 1 Kings 17, 17 to 23. 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 17 to 23. And it came to pass after these things that the son of the woman, the mistress of the house, fell sick, and his sickness was so sore that there was no breath left in him. And she said unto Elijah, what have I to do with thee? O thou man of God, had thou come unto me to call my sin to remembrance and to slay my son? And he said unto her, give me thy son. And he took him out of her bosom and carried him up into a loft where he abode, and laid him upon his own bed. And he cried unto the Lord and said, O Lord my God, hast thou also brought evil upon the widow with whom I sojourn by slaying her son? And he stretched himself upon the child 3 times and cried unto the Lord and said, O Lord my God, I pray thee, let this child's soul come into him again. And the Lord heard the voice of Elijah, and the soul of the child came into him again, and he revived. 23, the last verse. And Elijah took the child and brought him down out of the chamber into the house and delivered him unto his mother. And Elijah said, see, thy son liveth. I pray that the God who answered Elijah will answer you today in Jesus' name. So from where we are afraid, we can see that when the son of the widow died, he cried to Elijah. That's the form of prayer. She cried because she needed assistance. She wants her child back to life. Furthermore, when Rachel asked Jacob to give her children, she was praying. Genesis 31. Don't forget, we are giving definition to prayer in this passage as an outcry for assistance. Whatever form of outcry you made for assistance is referred to as prayers. In 2 Kings 6, 25 to 29, we see a woman praying to the king for help in enforcing her agreement to feed on another woman's son after her own son had been devoured. Two women agreed together. Okay, this famine is so sore. There's no more food left at home. They both agreed that they will eat their children. So the first child, the first woman killed her own son. They cut the meat, the body of the child, and they ate. So when it was the turn of the other woman said, never. Do what? Kill my own son? Eat my own son? Never. And so the first woman prayed to the king and said, King, this is beyond me. Come to my aid. We agreed together. Now this woman is breaking the agreement. From all these cases, it could be established that prayer can be made to different categories of people. You can make prayer to an individual. You can make prayer to kings. You can make prayer to men of God. And of course, you can make prayer to the Almighty God himself. Don't forget the angle at which we are looking at prayer. We are looking at prayer as an outcry for assistance. So you can cry to man. You can cry to your king or president. You can cry to the man of God, like the case of the widow cried to Elijah. And you can cry to Jehovah himself. People also pray to the devil and his agents when they go to them for help. There are some believers who go to their villages to cry to their unsaved parents for help over a nagging issue. Such parents are compelled to consult their oracles and apply charms in resolving these issues. When this occurs, that believer has been brought into covenant with the idols consulted, thereby giving the demonic spirits behind such idols the right to manipulate their lives. Maybe such believer has forgotten what is written in Isaiah 42:17. Isaiah 42:17. On no account should you, as a child of God, cry to your unsaved parents to come to your aid. Where is Jehovah? What can any man do without the help of God? Isaiah 42:17 says, they shall be turned back. They shall be greatly ashamed that trust in graven images, that say to molten images, ye are our gods. If you don't want to know shame, don't ever run to your safe parents to come to your aid, because they will run to idols. And you have heard the word of God. Whoever will run to idol is asking for shame. Be very careful who you run to for help Isaiah 31, 1. Isaiah chapter 31 and verse 1. Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help and stay on horses and trust in chariots because they are many and in horsemen because they are very strong, but they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord. If God say woe unto someone, you know that that life cannot be good. So we are not to run helter-skelter for help, but rather we run to God. Don't forget we are talking on misdirected requests. When Rachel asked Jacob to give her children, in Genesis 31, Jacob got angry. Rachel even threatened to commit suicide if she did not have children. Her husband's response in Genesis 32b says it all. Genesis 30, verse 2b. Am I in God's stead? Who are withheld from thee the fruit of the womb? This was directing our right request to the wrong quarters. What she was asking was beyond disability. Many times we pray to the wrong person or send our desires to those who cannot truly help us, forgetting what the word of God says in Psalm 60, verse 11. Psalm 60, 11 says, give us help from trouble, for vain is the help of man. Are you channeling your request to men instead of God? Stop doing so today. God is the only one with all the resources to meet all your needs. Therefore, it is wise to direct your entire request and cries to him alone. As you do so, he will hear you. Prayer point. One, we want to say, Father, visit all the widows in my local church. Meet their needs and that of their children. Let's pray. Our Lord and our God, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for the widows in the church. And we are praying, oh God, that we meet all the needs of these widows in the mighty name of Jesus. Every widow in our church, our Lord and our King, we pray for them today. Meet their needs. Meet their needs. Needs physical, needs spiritual, needs financial, needs marital, needs of all sorts. Father, please send help to them. Don't let them lose shame. Your promise to be husband to the widows. Lord God Almighty, arise and meet their needs in the name of Jesus. Meet the needs of their children also. Leke kesparata lida yakoro lobo chocho. Rege keke keselele yakaka linda lila yakakaria. Ringe kele bostotoria. In Jesus' name we pray. Still praying for the widows. We want to say, Father, keep them pure and ready for your coming. Almighty and everlasting God, we are committing all the widows in our churches into your hand. Please, Lord, keep them pure, keep them holy, keep them pure, keep them holy, keep them uncorrupted, keep them unpolluted, keep them for your coming in the name of Jesus. The grace for all these widows, oh God, to live a holy life in the secret and in the open, release upon them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Redeemer. You want to say, Father, we bring all the cases of waiting mothers before you. Please remember them like you remember Rachel. Our Lord and our God, we thank you because we are the same. You have not changed. And we have been taught today that we should be directing our requests to you. Therefore, Lord, all your true children that are waiting on you for the fruit of the womb, Father, remember them. 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 Father, remember them because of your name. Please remember them. As many as are true children of God that are trusting you for the fruit of the womb, you that remember Rachel, remember them. You that put laughter in the mouth of Sarah, remember them. Litaya bako korobo stekelende rege kekelianda ya karibaba basotoria. You that opened the womb of Rebecca, remember them in the name of Jesus. Now tell him your own personal problem. You have learned now that to ask man or king or even man of God to solve your problem is misdirecting your request. Ask the living God now.
strength.
Thank you, Father. Our Lord and our God, the only God that hears and answers prayer. Every prayer request we have raised before you today, hear and answer in Jesus' name. Thank you, blessed Redeemer. Glory in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can we please sing in
sing out. Yeah.